How are you, friend? Today we are going to learn English Standard 7th Literature Reader Chapter 1 The Eagle. The Eagle is written by the Lord Alfred Tennyson, was an English court poet during the reign of Queen Victoria of London and was given the title Poet Laureate. Dear friend, The Eagle by Alfred Lord Tennyson is a short two-stanza poem that speaks on the power and the solitude of a lone eagle on a rocky cliff. The poem begins with the speaker describing how a solitary eagle is standing on the top of a craggy cliff, from where he is perched with his crooked hands gripping the rocks. He can survey the whole azure world around and below him. Tennyson's eagle is in a real place of power, and as soon as he is ready to, and not a moment sooner, he dives. In the final line, he makes his surprise move, barreling down towards the water in search of prey. Let's start the poem. Dear friend, he claps the crag with the crooked hands, close to the sun in the lonely lands. Ring with the azure world he stand, the wrinkled sea beneath him crawls. He watches from his mountain walls, and like a thunderbolt he falls. Now let understand some of the words which make us easy to understand this poem. First, claps means hold firmly or tightly. Crag, that means cliff, a steep rugged rock. Azure, a light shade of blue, blue sky. Crawl, move slowly, beneath, below, to lower place. Thunderbolt, bolt of lightning. Dear friend, let understand the poem. He claps the crag with the crooked hands, close to the sun in the lonely lands, ringed with the azure world he stand. This piece begins with the descriptions of a creature, only labeled with the pronoun he. The speaker is assuming that a reader will understand who this he is. And if one reads the title of the poem, it's clear Tennyson's speaker is describing an eagle who is at the moment the poem start up on the crag, meaning a rugged, exposed cliff face. This is somewhere human beings couldn't or would have trouble reaching. There is something transcendent about the opening scene. It is beyond that which humanity can experience, except through the words of writer, such as Tennyson. Alfred Lord Tennyson also make use of alliterations in this first line in order to increase the rhythm of the phrase. Additionally, with that, the personification is also used. Dear friend, the simplicity of the rhyme in this line carries the poem forward. It is contrasted by the dramatic image Tennyson has crafted. This only expand as he discusses the lonely lands that stretch out the underneath the crag. This emphasizes the feeling of a loneliness and the isolations. Dear friend, let's see the second stanza. The wrinkled sea beneath him crawls. He watches from his mountain walls, and like a thunderbolt he falls. In the second stanza, the speaker gives the reader a few more details about the eagle surrounding the rocky cliff on which the creature is perched. As already made clear, very steep, the Tennyson adds that it is also jutting out over the sea. Dear friend, the eagle is so high up, the sea appeared to be covered in wrinkles. They represent the various shapes of the waves and the might makes one consider how age and time play into these descriptions. In the next line, the eagle positions of a power on the rocks is emphasized. He is high above everything else and is able to watch. That's a very important thing. What's going on below and around him? A reader could also take notes of how Tennyson called the mountain walls the eagle walls, as if they belong to him. He has a claim over the piece of land, and because he is the only creature capable of reaching it, there is no one to challenge him. The transition from the second line to the third is powerful. All of a sudden, the eagle drops from his perch. Before ending of this poem, let be familiar with the summary. Dear friend, the poem begins with the speaker describing how a solitary eagle is standing on the top of the craggy cliff, from where he is perched with his crooked hand gripping the rocks. He can survey the whole azure world around and below him. Tennyson's eagle is in the real place of power, and as soon as he is ready to, and not to the moment sooner, he divides. In the final line, he makes his surprise move, barreling down towards the water in search of prey. Thank you so much.